live and in color. From the Broadway Theater in New York City, the Miss USA Beauty Pageant. Tonight, the judges will choose Miss USA, the one beautiful girl who will represent the United States in the pageant that chooses the most beautiful girl on earth, Miss Universe. And now, competing for that honor, from the 50 states and the District of Columbia, here are the most beautiful girls in the USA. Tonight's special guest stars, the Letterman. And your host, one of television's most popular personalities, Mr. Bob Barker. The Miss USA Beauty Pageant is brought to you by Camé for your beautiful complexion. And by Downy, the fabric softener that makes your clothes smell extra fresh. And by Crest, the cavity fighter.
All across the land and we've been waiting. Just for tonight we're all so proud. At the chance to be competing, each and every state sends you its greeting. And when the judges make their final tabulation, you wait and see Miss USA for the year that's just beginning.
Gentlemen, here is your host, Mr. Bob Barker.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Miss USA Beauty Pageant, the newest hit show on Broadway. This year, the pageant is lighting up the Great White Way in New York City with 51 brand new stars here on this stage of the Broadway Theater. And you have a front row center seat for all the beauty and excitement of this 22nd annual pageant. Before the show is over, one lucky girl will step into the spotlight as Miss USA of 1973. And even on Broadway, that's a finale that's hard to beat. Now, these judges here will select that girl from our 51 beautiful contestants. And that very special young lady will represent the United States in the Miss Universe pageant on July 21st in Athens, Greece. Now, I've had the pleasure of getting to know each of these girls during the past week of rehearsals, and I can honestly say that the new Miss USA could come from any one of the 50 states or the District of Columbia. So wherever you are right now, your state representative could be named the most beautiful girl in the United States. Now, before tonight's competition begins, I have two young ladies I should like to have join our royal court here. First, the reigning Miss USA, the beautiful girl from Hawaii, who walked off with the title just a year ago. Miss USA of 1972, Tanya Wilson. Yes, and now may I present the reigning Miss Universe from Australia. Here is Carrie Ann Wells. Now, tonight's final judging begins with a traditional parade of states. Each of our delegates will introduce herself and tell us her hometown as she comes out to greet you. Now, she'll hand in her vote for the Miss Amity Award. Each year, this award is voted to the girl who, in the opinion of her fellow delegates, has been the most friendly and popular throughout the busy week of the pageant. And next to the Miss USA crown itself, this award is the one that the girls consider the very most important award of all. The votes will be tallied right here on this board during the parade of states. And right after the last contestant, Miss Wyoming, has introduced herself, I will announce the name of Miss Amity for 1973. So let's meet the 51 beauty delegates to this 22nd annual Miss USA beauty pageant. Here they are in the parade of states. Miss Alabama.
Good evening, I'm Diane Fouillet from Enterprise.
Miss Alaska.
Hello, I'm Wendy Kerwin from Fairbanks.
Miss Arizona.
Hello, I'm Sherry Elaine Nix from Phoenix.
Miss Arkansas.
Hello, I'm Crystal Pfeiffer from Texarkana.
Miss California.
Hi, I'm Carol Marie Harima from Artesia.
Miss Colorado.
Hi, I'm Lenita Mosley from Denver.
Miss Connecticut.
Good evening, I'm Wendy Beccarino from Danbury.
Miss Delaware.
Hi, I'm Linda Graves from Wilmington.
Miss District of Columbia.
Good evening, I'm Nancy Placta of Adelphi from our nation's capital.
Miss Florida.
Hello, I'm Stacy Evans from Daytona Beach.
Miss Georgia.
Hi, I'm Melanie Chapman from Atlanta.
Miss Hawaii.
Aloha, I'm Kuipo Dubell from Kaneohe.
Miss Idaho.
Greetings from Idaho. My name is Karen Hammond from Rexburg.
Miss Illinois.
Amanda Jones Evanston, home of the Women's Christian Temperance Union.
Miss Indiana.
Hi, I'm Debbie Osavar from Gary.
Miss Iowa.
Good evening, I'm Diane Roberts from Oskaloosa.
Miss Kansas.
Hello, I'm Brenda Coatmeyer from Overland Park.
Miss Kentucky.
Hello, I'm Nancy Copeland from Mayfield.
Miss Louisiana.
Hi, I'm Sergeant Storm Hensley, Barstow Air Force Base from Shreveport and Bossier City.
Miss Maine.
Brenda Davis from Southwest Harbor.
Miss Maryland.
Hi, my name is Betty Jo Grove, and I'm from College Park, Maryland.
Miss Massachusetts.
Good evening, I'm Judith Gregory from Boston.
Miss Michigan.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Linda East from Warren.
Miss Minnesota.
Hello, Cindy James, Minneapolis.
Miss Mississippi.
Hello, I'm Karen Clements from Jackson.
Miss Missouri.
Hello, I'm Camilla Chris from Shelbina.
Miss Montana.
Hi, I'm Jerry Shander from Missoula.
Miss Nebraska voted Miss Pixable.
Hi, Janice Schuyler from Omaha.
Miss Nevada.
Laura Fritz from Las Vegas.
Miss New Hampshire.
Hi, I'm Grace Knox from Plymouth.
Miss New Jersey.
Good evening, I'm Patricia Everett from Runnymede.
Miss New Mexico.
Greetings from the land of enchantment. I'm Carolyn Klein from Albuquerque.
Miss New York.
I'm Susie Carlson from Schenectady.
Miss North Carolina.
Hello, I'm Vivian Craig from Stanley, North Carolina.
Miss North Dakota.
Good evening, I'm Barbara Lundeen from Minot.
Miss Ohio.
Hello, I'm Jacqueline Bannock from Cleveland.
Miss Oklahoma.
Hello, I'm Martha Buchanan from Stillwater.
Miss Oregon.
Hi, I'm Judy Bishop from Portland.
Miss Pennsylvania.
Hi, my name is Jill Umbawas from Benton.
Miss Rhode Island.
Hi, I'm Gail White from Providence.
Miss South Carolina.
Hello, I'm Kiki Kirkland from Newberry.
Miss South Dakota.
Good evening, I'm Becky Bunkers from Brookings.
Miss Tennessee.
Hello, I'm Tommy Hooker from Memphis.
Miss Texas, tied for best state costume.
Hello, I'm LaVon McConnell from Haltom City.
Miss Utah.
Hi, I'm Julia Nebaker from Nephi.
Miss Vermont.
Hello, I'm Bonnie Height from Pulteney.
Miss Virginia.
Hi, I'm Brenda Childers from Richmond.
Miss Washington.
Good evening. I'm Cindy Arnett from Bellevue.
Miss West Virginia.
Hello, I'm Kathy Rowan from Pinch.
Miss Wisconsin, tied for best state costume. Miss Wyoming.
Howdy, I'm Michelle Walter from Cheyenne.
And there it is, the parade of Miss USA beauties for 1973. And now, the name of the winner of the Miss Amity Award for 1973. It has just been handed to me by Chuck Zing. The winner, Miss South Carolina. Kiki is so excited, she's falling apart here.
Yeah.
Congratulations, Kiki.
Thank you kindly.
I think this is a very, very popular decision.
Oh, well, no bad.
Now,
Let's talk about it later.
No, now, Kiki, you told me, listen, you told me during rehearsals that all you wanted was the opportunity to say hello to your millions of fans.
Is that all I told you I wanted?
No, Kiki is a very lovable little nut. And Kiki, in the future now, let me get in there with you if I'm going to talk with you. In the future, if you should ever have trouble with your husband, you can always tell him it's his fault because you're Miss Amity, right?
Okay.
Congratulations, Miss Amity, and thank you, Beauty Delegates, for 1973.
I want to welcome you all to the Miss USA Beauty Pageant. This is the pageant's 22nd year, but it's the very first time it's ever been held in New York City. I'm in the anchor booth, which has been specially built just for tonight. It's the place where I get a chance to watch the action down below and share it all with you at home. We're in the Broadway Theater, and if theaters could talk, what stories this one could tell. The girls are standing on the very stage where just about all of Broadway's greatest stars have appeared. I almost think if you listen very closely, you'll still hear a faint echo of Ethel Merman singing, "Everything's coming up roses." Well, everything is coming up roses for our 51 beautiful contestants tonight, and it's just beginning. Since it isn't easy to keep track of so many girls, why not get a pencil and paper and make notes of your choices for the 12 semifinalists and then the 5 finalists. Not only can you cheer for your favorites, but it's fun to see how often you agree with the judges. First, however, here are some notes about complexion care from Camé, the beauty cleanser.
I'm sure that if we took a poll, we'd find that the swimsuit competition is one of the most popular features of the Miss USA Beauty Pageant. Last year, in addition to the swimsuit parade in which the 12 semifinalists compete, we presented a special swimsuit spectacular that featured all 51 contestants. Now, we're delighted to bring you a brand new 1973 edition, this time using a ferry boat as a camera platform and the magnificent New York Harbor skyline as a backdrop. The day began warm and sunny, but as we cruised around the harbor, it grew colder and colder and windier, so let's join all 51 wind-blown, goosebump beauties on the Staten Island Ferry. Now, this is the Brooklyn Bridge here, and we have the girls from the South and Southwest. First, Miss Alabama. Miss Arkansas. Miss District of Columbia. Miss Florida. Miss Georgia. Miss Kentucky. Miss Louisiana. Miss Mississippi. Miss North Carolina. Miss Oklahoma. Miss South Carolina, who just became Miss Amity. Miss Tennessee. Miss Texas. And Miss Virginia. And now at the United Nations, the beauty delegates from the West. Miss Alaska. Miss Arizona. Miss California. Miss Colorado. Miss Hawaii. Miss Idaho. Miss Montana. Miss Nevada. Miss New Mexico. Miss Oregon. Miss Utah. Miss Washington. And Miss Wyoming. Here at the Statue of Liberty are the contestants from the Central and Midwest states. Miss Illinois. Miss Indiana. Miss Iowa. Miss Kansas. Miss Michigan. Miss Minnesota. Miss Missouri. Miss Nebraska. Miss North Dakota. Miss Ohio. Miss South Dakota. And Miss Wisconsin. And now, framed by Lower Manhattan, are the beauty delegates from the East. Miss Connecticut. Miss Delaware. Miss Maine. Miss Maryland. Miss Massachusetts. Miss New Hampshire. Miss New Jersey. Miss New York. Miss Pennsylvania. Miss Rhode Island. Miss Vermont. And Miss West Virginia.
Here are our 51 beauty delegates in their swimsuits on the Staten Island Ferry with the New York skyline in the background.
In 5 minutes after they finished taping, the cold rain began to fall and you never saw so many goosebumps. Have you noticed that these young ladies seem taller than in previous years? Well, they are. The average height among our delegates is 5 feet 8 inches, and brunettes still outnumber blondes 3 to 1. You know, since a few of the girls are planning to become actresses, it's just possible that the Schuberts, who run the Broadway Theater, are looking at one of their future stars right here tonight. Barbara Streisand became a superstar on this very stage in Funny Girl, so it could happen to one of our contestants. Well, Broadway's the street of dreams, and tonight, for one girl, her dream will really come true with the crowning of Miss USA 1973. Now, here are some folks who feel there's no place like a home that uses Downy fabric softener.
As I've said, one of these girls will compete in the Miss Universe pageant to be held in Athens, Greece on July 21st. And with us tonight is the Consul General of Greece, John Billy Matsis. Let's welcome him. It's an honor to have you with us, sir. Now, during the past week, our judges here, in order to cast their votes on poise, personality, and general appearance, have met with each of our beauty delegates individually. Their secret ballots have been tabulated, and the 12 contestants with the highest scores have been selected as semifinalists. Now, here in their Kiana dresses are all 51 of our beauty delegates for 1973. Now, may I have the list of semifinalists, please? Now, I want to remind you that the judges cast their ballots individually and secretly. Neither the girls nor I know the names of the semifinalists. In fact, not even these judges themselves know which 12 girls they have chosen collectively. But their names are right here on this card. They are not listed alphabetically. Here are the names of this year's Miss USA semifinalists. Now, you have been a wonderful group of girls to work with. Good luck to all of you. The first of our semifinalists is Miss Arizona. Number two, our second semifinalist is Miss Florida. Here are two of our semifinalists. We have 10 more names on this list, and one of them is Miss Kansas. Semifinalist number four, it is Miss Nebraska. And now, to join our first four semifinalists, here comes Miss Rhode Island. For our next girl, we go west. We go west. Here is Miss California. Here are our first six. These are half of our semifinalists. The next name on this list, it is Miss Texas. Now, number eight, Miss District of Columbia. Number nine, I think this one you will approve. It is Miss New York. Now we're getting near the end of our list. We're down to number 10. Who is number 10? Number 10 is Miss Louisiana. Now we have only two more girls who have a chance to go on to become Miss USA of 1973. Only two more. One of those girls is Miss Illinois. And now, number 12, the last of our semifinalists is Miss Maryland. And there they are, our Miss USA semifinalists for 1973.
In New York City for a whole week has really been a terrific adventure for all the girls. They've worked very hard putting this show together, and they deserve a lot of credit. They also managed to have a good time exploring, and here's a short film we made we'd like you to see. They've never been to New York, and each day brought some new sightseeing adventures. They visited St. Patrick's Cathedral, statues in Herald Square, beautiful fountains at Lincoln Center, and of course, the United Nations. One afternoon, some of the girls took a hansom cab ride to Central Park with Miss Vermont handling the reins beautifully. The contestants enjoyed the magnificent views of the city that the park provides and then made a beeline for the famous Central Park Zoo. Obviously, Miss USA delegates are at home on both sides of a camera. Miss Rhode Island fed this hungry seal, and then Miss Illinois did her own impersonation of it. The wild animals seemed to like the girls, but it was the more domesticated species that got all of the personal attention. Of course, sightseeing makes tourists hungry, and the Miss USA girls have plenty of time for all kinds of snacks and picnic lunches. For those who like their dining a little more elegant, there was Rockefeller Center, where all the contestants enjoyed a delicious lunch, surrounded by waterfalls and statues, and of course, happy memories of their exciting week in New York City. And now, meet a woman who really depends on Tide.
We've introduced our 12 semifinalists, and now I'm going to chat with each of them, beginning with Miss Arizona. Miss Arizona, would you come right down here? She's Sherry Nix. She's from Phoenix. She's a student at Phoenix City College, and you were the first one chosen. That must have been an exciting moment, huh?
Yes, it was. I just hope I can remember where I'm going. Now that I've never won, I was always hoping someone would be in front of me.
You mean where you walk next on
right,
the stage?
Right, right. Yes.
Well, you don't. You just walk right out this aisle and out,
okay.
Right up here.
I might do
no,
that.
No, I'll point you in the right direction. Now, you're from a big family, aren't you, Sherry?
Oh, yes, I am. I have four sisters and a brother and a cat named D.C. And my parents aren't included in that number.
And you're the oldest of the children?
Yes, I am.
How is it being the oldest in a big family like this, Sherry?
I would call myself the bricklayer.
Because, in what way?
Well, it's gotten to the point where if they want to know if they can do something or not, well, let Sherry do it, and then we'll find out. If she gets away with it, then we know we can do it. So it doesn't happen too often, though, because I've gotten wise to them.
Now that you've become a semifinalist, though, we can expect your sisters at the USA pageant,
aren't
they?
Yes, you can, for sure.
Well, thank you, Miss Arizona, and we'd love to have them, and you just take your place right out there. Now, I'm going to talk with Miss Florida. Miss Florida here is Stacey Evans. She lives in Daytona Beach. She's a student at the University of Florida. And here you are, a semifinalist, and you won a beauty title recently, didn't you, Stacy?
Yes, sir, I did. I won the Florida Azalea Queen.
The Florida Azalea Queen? And
yes,
you
sir.
Won some money for that, did you?
Yes, I won $1,000.
What did you do with that money?
Well, I took the money because I didn't want to just cash it in and not have anything to show for it, so I took flying lessons.
Well, fine. I think that's fine. And now you're a flyer. What else do you do down in Florida?
Well, I do a lot of body surfing.
Is that difficult?
Well, the only thing really difficult with it is keeping your top on.
Keeping your top on?
Because the wave is so...
Don't explain it. I understand perfectly. No, I've body surfed, but I've never had that problem, Stacy. I never have. But congratulations on becoming a semifinalist. And will you join Miss Arizona?
Thank you. Mm-hmm.
Now, Miss Kansas. Miss Kansas here is Brenda Kopmeyer. She's from Overland Park. She's a student at the University of Kansas. And how about it now, Brenda? If you should win, there's a lot of money involved here, $7,500 in cash and
That's
a $7,500
right.
guarantee through the year. What will you do with all your money?
Well, first of all, I've got a loan at school to pay back. Mm-hmm. And secondly, I have two older brothers at home that feel that they need hair transplants.
Transplants?
So I told them if I was lucky enough to win, I'd I'd buy them.
To buy transplants?
Buy some hair for them.
This suddenly sounds like Queen for a Day, doesn't it? Brenda, how old are your brothers?
I have one that's 23 and the other one's 26.
And their hair, they're losing their hair.
I better not say they are.
Well, you better not buy them transplants if they're not, Brenda. But I was thinking, if you see these two fellas walking down the street there in Kansas with lots of hair, you'll know Brenda is Miss USA, right?
Right.
Thank you very much, Miss Kansas. Now, Miss Nebraska, would you join me, please? This is Janice Geiler. She's from Omaha. She's a receptionist at a television station. She won the Miss Pixable Award. That must have been a thrill, huh?
It certainly was. It's unexpected.
With these beautiful girls, you should be very, very pleased with that. How about you? Have a boyfriend, do you?
Boyfriends?
You have boyfriends?
Yes.
Uh-huh. What sort of boyfriends do you like, Mr. Nebraska?
Well, I sort of like men who are a little bit older than I.
Older men?
Yes.
Yes. How old?
32, 33, 34.
Oh. Are these 32 and 33-year-old boys watching you back in Omaha?
Well, they're in Omaha, they're all over, actually.
How do you have boyfriends all over, Janice? Have you been to New York before?
Just once.
But that was enough. Does your boyfriend...
Well, I have friends. I make friends through my business contacts and through school.
Uh-huh.
And...
Well, did the boys in the East know about the boys in the West?
Of course not.
Well, I have news for you. They do right now on CBS, believe me. Thank you, Miss Nebraska. Will you join Miss Kansas out here? Miss Rhode Island, let's talk with you next. This is Gail White. She's from Providence. She's a secretary. And you also are from a big family, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
How many in your family?
8 children. I have 4 sisters and 3 brothers.
Well, I just touched on that with this one young lady. How about it? What are the problems with a big family? Are there any problems?
Well, one of the assets in a big family is that if you have an argument with one, you always have 6 others to speak with.
There's always somebody to talk to. Do you have arguments about what sort of things?
Oh, 7 bananas and 8 kids, or who's going to sit in the back seat, or who has to sit next to the dog.
Well, you could never all get in the same car anyway, could you?
We have a 9-passenger car.
Oh, you do? Uh-huh.
It's like a school bus, like you're going to camp all the time.
I see. You're studying karate, aren't
you? Yes, I am.
You having fun doing that?
Love it.
Just imagine for a moment that we'll do a demonstration here. Suppose you're walking down a dark street and right here. And I'm behind you and I come along and I suddenly grab you. What do you do?
I would scream as loud as I could and I'd bang like this.
Now that's enough. Yeah. Did you see the look on this lady's face in the front row? You thought I was joining, but you really know what you're doing. Fine, Mr. Rhode Island. Thank you for talking with me. And now, Miss California, right up here with me. And Miss California is Carol Harriman. And where do you live in California?
In Artesia.
And what do you do there?
Well, I go to school full-time and I work part-time.
Yes, and you were telling us here that you have a boyfriend who looks just like you?
Yes, they always think he's my brother and it's kind of odd when we hold hands.
Well, now, is your boyfriend watching you back in California?
No, he's right here.
Oh, he's here in the audience? What's his name?
Pete.
Pete, where are you, Pete? Stand up. Where's Pete? There's Pete, right in the middle of the house right there. Yes. Pete, you know, you do look a little like Carol. You do look a little like, except for the mustache, you understand, but you do. What?
You can see it.
Can't you?
Well, I always tease him about it.
Well, I'll bet one thing, Pete. I'll bet she does a lot better in the swimsuit competition than you would. Here you go, right out here. And these are our first 6 semifinalists for 1973.
Semifinalists, and you've had a chance to learn a little bit about them from their talk with Bob. Of course, I had a chance to talk to most of the girls, and there's not one who hasn't told me that this pageant has been the biggest thrill of her life. Just imagine being a young lady in a very small town, as most of the girls are, or many of them, and then being selected as the prettiest girl in your whole state. Now add to that the excitement of a week in New York filled with days of sightseeing and dinners in fabulous restaurants. evenings on Broadway seeing wonderful plays like Sleuth and Sugar, all that, and a chance to compete for the title of Miss USA. The girls begin the week just a little timidly by making friends with girls from neighboring states, but after a while, their chums reach from coast to coast. Win or lose, it's an event they remember their whole lives. And now, two generations who agree on lovely dishes and lemon fresh joy.
We're talking with our Miss USA semifinalists, and next I'd like to talk with Miss Texas, if I may. She's LaVon McConnell. She's from Fort Worth. She's a student at Tarrant County Junior College, right?
Right.
And you had something kind of exciting happen during pageant week.
Yes, I had a birthday, and they gave me two birthday parties.
You became 20 years old
yes,
with us. And
no longer
tell us about those birthday parties, why don't you?
Well, first of all, we all went to Wednesday's restaurant. It was a discotheque. We ate supper, and the girls all came out, and everybody brought a big cake out, and I cut the cake and handed the cake out, and everyone went on dancing and singing happy birthday.
Mm-hmm.
And then when I got back to the hotel, after I'd brushed my hair out and taken my shoes off, my roommate came running in, and she says, "Go upstairs. Miss Tucker needs to talk to everyone." And I said, "Okay," you know, so I took off upstairs and I walked in. There was another cake and everyone was singing happy birthday.
Well, I think that's very nice. Now, I've been talking with, somehow we've gotten off on men with some of our semifinalists, and we've heard about the great guys down there in Texas. What's so different about Texas men?
Their accents.
I feel much better somehow. I really do. Thank you, Miss Texas. Let's talk now with Miss District of Columbia. This is Nancy Plaktis. She's from Adelphi. She's a student at the University of Maryland, and in addition to being a student, you're a program specialist for different cities. What is a program specialist? What do you do? Well, first of all, what cities do you do this for?
For Adelphi, Silver Spring, Washington, Greenbelt, Mount Rainier, etc. A program specialist is the title they gave me because I teach ballet, jazz, Hawaiian, synchronized swimming, Red Cross swimming, handicap swimming, and Swedish exercise. And on my paycheck, they couldn't put that.
Well, I can believe that. How in the world do you have time to go to school?
Well, I fit it in between my school classes. I also, a lot of my classes this year because I graduated today.
Well,
so,
congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I sent my brother, so I hope I graduated. But anyway,
you sent him to get your diploma?
Yeah, he took my place.
Well, I just met a young lady who's sending hers to get transplants, so why not a diploma?
Well,
but you're busy. Well, you were telling me how busy you are. How many hours a day do you work?
Well, it varies from day to day.
How'd you have time to enter this pageant? Why did you enter the pageant? Tell me about it.
I entered the pageant for a lot of reasons. One, to prove something to yourself. It offers advantages. I think everybody knows it's a stepping stone to modeling careers, theatrics, and I've admired the past Miss USAs.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think that's very nice, and I'm sure that the people who are seeing you now on CBS will be admiring you, Miss District of Columbia. Thank you. Miss New York, would you come out here and join me? This is Susie Carlson. She's from Schenectady. She's a high school student, and you're the youngest of our beauty contestants here in New York. How old are you?
I was 18 April 30th.
How about preparing for the pageant now? What did you do, Susie, to get ready to be a delegate here?
Well, I decided to go on a diet to lose a little weight. And in fact, my birthday cake's home in my freezer.
Really? When was your birthday?
April 30th.
And you've left that birthday cake right there.
Mm-hmm.
Has the pageant been pretty much what you expected?
Well, it's been a lot more practicing and a lot more work than I thought it would be.
Well, I think that that's a very good point. These girls do rehearse many hours for this telecast, and you've all been so happy and smiling. How do you stay so happy, Susie?
Well, I think of things that make me happy.
What did you think about to make you happy?
Eating my birthday cake.
Thank you, Susie, very much. Miss Louisiana, you come on out here now, will you please? She is, believe it or not, this young lady is a sergeant in the United States Air Force. This is Storm Hensley from Bossier City. And Storm, I think our audience would love to hear about your career. Now, how long have you been in the Air Force?
Well, it'll be 4 years in September, and I've enjoyed every moment of it.
Now, you must have enjoyed it, because I understand you've signed over for another hit.
Right. The beginning of January, I had assignment orders to go to Germany, and I couldn't pass it up, so I re-enlisted. And right now, I'm on administrative hold until I give up my title in the state.
Well, Sergeant, how did you decide to join the Air Force?
Well, mainly for the educational opportunity. I'm a little broke. And I figured after I serve my country, I'll go to college, and I'll have a 4-year college, and I'll get on the GI Bill.
That's
plus,
right.
I'm saving money. I've got quite a bit of money now.
Yeah.
And that was my main purpose behind
you
it.
You see, these girls aren't just pretty. They're bright, too. I think that's fine. Now, if I were interviewing, there's a gentleman in the Air Force who wants to applaud. If I were interviewing a young man in the Air Force, I might ask him about basic training. How was basic training for you, Sergeant?
Well, it was the longest. I didn't think it was ever going to end. The first 5 weeks, we had to march, and we had to do most everything that the guys had to do, except we didn't have to go through mud puddles or climb ropes or shoot a gun. And then the last week, they taught us to become a lady again.
Well, they certainly did well with you.
Thank you
very much, Miss Louisiana. Miss Illinois, would you step up here to me, please? This is Amanda Jones. Amanda is from Evanston. And Amanda, what do you do?
I'm a freelance actress in Chicago with modeling and TV commercials and conventions.
Fine. Good for you. How did you go about preparing yourself to be an actress, Amanda? What's important, do you think?
Physical stamina, first of all. There's a lot of hard work and a lot of psychology involved in you and the people you're around.
I see. And how did you prepare yourself, psychology-wise?
I took fencing.
How did that do anything for you psychologically?
Well, fencing has always been kind of a physical chess game to me. And when you look at your opponent, the way you look, the way you stand, can make a lot of difference in how your opponent is going to fight you.
How do you look if you're not very effective? How do you look?
You stand slouched, you hold your helmet, you hold your foil, and you kind of look around the room and... Like,
well,
you don't care.
If you want to go out there and be a winner, how do you look?
You stand up straight, you hold your helmet, you hold your foil, and you say, "We who are about to kill you salute you."
In other words, you think positively.
Right.
Have you tried that here at the pageant?
Not insofar as going out to win, whether I kill anybody or myself or not, just to have a great time, which I have had.
Good. I'll bet you have too, Miss Illinois. It's been great having you here. Now, would you join me, Miss Maryland? Miss Maryland here is Betty Jo Grove. And Betty Jo, where do you live?
I live in College Park.
And what do you do?
I go to school, University of Maryland.
And you said that you wanted to get married when you were 29 and 3/4 years old. Why 29 and 3/4?
Well, I want to get them before I get too old. I mean, 30 just seems too old.
Yes, it's ancient. It really is. Ancient. What are you studying at the University of Maryland?
I'm in fashion design.
Well, I'll bet you'll do very well. Thank you for talking with me, too, Miss Maryland. There you go. And it's time now for our 12 semifinalists to get ready for the swimsuit competition. Thank you, girls. Thank you very much.
I'm sitting with a young lady who's giving up her crown tonight. Tanya Wilson, Miss USA of 1972. Hi, Tanya.
Hello, Helen. How are you tonight?
Oh, I'm all right, but I want to know about you. Are you sorry about your reign ending this evening?
Not really. I am more excited, I think, than even last year, and I've had a terrific year, but at the same time, I can be very happy for the girl that has the same opportunities that I have coming to her.
That's very nice of you. What were some of the outstanding moments that you remember?
Oh, there have been so many. The traveling was quite extensive. I was in over 40 states. Perhaps attending the inauguration of the president was quite a highlight. And I thoroughly enjoyed Mexico. We parasailed in Acapulco Bay, yes. Even our chaperone went. And climbed pyramids for 8 hours at the Yucatan. And also got a pretty good suntan.
We were careful. What sort of things did you learn this year, honey?
Well, to keep a very good sense of humor. You can't get upset if you're getting up at 4:30 to catch planes, or if planes are non-existent, or if baggage does not arrive with you. But I think the most important thing is the people that I've met have been so tremendous, and even though I've only known them for a short time, they've really become very good friends.
Oh, that's very nice. I'm sure you're right about that. But we left out something very special that happened to you this year, didn't we?
That's right. I became engaged this year and met my fiancé in Puerto Rico, and it was a very whirlwind courtship. I met him just the day before I was leaving on tour, so we sort of dated throughout the United States.
That was a whirlwind. How long did it take you to say yes?
Oh, goodness. We discussed it, I think, the first time we went out, but it took us a couple weeks to really decide.
Could you guess about how many autographs you signed this year?
Oh, goodness. Completely rough estimate, 15,000. I really don't know.
That's
there have been so many people. I think I signed my last one this evening on my way up to see you.
Did you cry?
No, but it sort of struck home. It really did.
Yeah, you're going to change your name anyway, so maybe it's just as well. There's your last one, your last one for Miss Tanya Wilson. Tanya, I really wish you great luck, happiness, and success in whatever you do.
Thank you. Thank you.
It's been a pleasure talking to you. Lots of good luck.
It's been a great year. Thanks,
darling.
Girls are changing into their swimsuits. Here are our special guests for tonight, three very talented vocalists who make up one of the country's most popular singing groups. Let's welcome the Letterman.
Trees swaying in the summer breeze, showing off their silver leaves as we walked by. Soft kisses on a summer's day, laughing all our cares away, just you and I. Sweet, sleepy warmth of summer nights, gazing at the distant lights in the starry sky. They say that all good things must end someday. Autumn leaves must fall, but don't you know that it hurts me so to say goodbye to you? Wish you didn't have to go. Oh no, no, no. And when the rain beats against my window pane, I'll think of summer days again and dream of you. They say that all good things must end someday. Autumn leaves must fall, but don't you know that it hurts me so to say goodbye to you. Wish you didn't have to go. Oh no, no, no. And when the rain beats against my window pane, I think of summer days again and dream of you. And dream of you.
Thank you very much, Letterman. We'll have an encore from the Letterman shortly. Before we move on to the swimsuit competition, I'd like to have you meet the panel of experts whose job it is to choose Miss USA for 1973. First, Arlene Dahl, the beautiful motion picture actress and successful businesswoman. Commander Scott Carpenter, one of the seven original United States astronauts and one of the first Americans to orbit the Earth. Patrick O'Neill, one of Broadway's finest performers as well as a star of television and motion pictures. Dr. Joyce Brothers, popular psychologist, author, columnist, and star of her own new television series, Living Easy. Joe Frazier, former heavyweight champion of the world. Joe, these girls look as if they've been doing their road work, don't they? Huh? Yes, they have. Peter Max, award-winning contemporary artist and sculptor. Joey Adams, internationally known comedian and author and ambassador of goodwill for two presidents. Jacqueline Suzanne, author of the new number one bestseller, Once Is Not Enough. Halston, internationally acclaimed American designer and fashion trendsetter. Maria Romeni Cantrell, Miss USA of 1966. And Dr. Erwin Stillman, a leading authority on health and diet. Thank you, judges.
You know, this is the time the judges use to review their first choices and single them out for closer study. Incidentally, this theater has been a movie house, a vaudeville showplace, a legitimate theater, but it's the very first time it's ever been the home of a beauty pageant. The biggest star on Broadway doesn't make much more than $1,000 a night, but just think what's in store for the future Miss USA for a single night's performance. All 12 of the semifinalists know that the lucky young lady who actually wins the crown receives a $7,500 cash prize, a $7,500 service contract, gifts, a year-round wardrobe, and an opportunity to represent the United States in the Miss Universe pageants. What nobody but Miss USA herself can know is what a year's travel and personal appearances can mean in terms of growth and maturity. Throughout the 1 year of her reign, she'll meet people and have experiences that she might have not have had in a lifetime. It's a rare opportunity for that one special girl each year. Well, it's time to see our 12 semifinalists in the swimsuit competition, and I know that none of you want to miss that. So just sit tight while we watch what happens when a bride fries chicken in Crisco oil. Difficult for the judges, and there's no doubt in my mind that all these babies must have been really beautiful babies when they were little. Of course, I love all little babies, but anyway, to prove my point, here are a few of our semifinalists when they were young enough to be bouncing on the knees of their proud parents. This is the first one. This is Miss Arizona. It's hard to believe she's the same person, isn't it? That's cute. And then we have Miss Louisiana. Isn't that adorable? It's the same girl, just more of her. Oh, they're so pretty. And Miss Illinois. Now, they knew she was going to be beautiful when she was little. I just know it. I wish I had more pictures and more time to show you, but, well, dear, there it is. There's time now for Bob to be telling you more about the contest. Okay, Bob.
We saw all 51 of this year's beauty delegates in their swimsuits, and now it's time for our 12 semifinalists to take part in the actual swimsuit competition. This is a very important part of tonight's judging. While you're watching the girls, our judges will be marking their ballots very, very carefully. Now, here they are in their Catalina swimsuits, our 12 Miss USA semifinalists in the 1973 swimsuit competition. Miss Arizona.
That's Sherry Nix. She's 5'8" tall and weighs 113 pounds. She has blonde hair and brown eyes, as you can see. She's from Phoenix. And she's 21 years old.
Miss Florida.
Stacy Evans. She's from Daytona Beach. 21 years old. She has blonde hair and hazel eyes. She's 5'6" tall and weighs 115 pounds.
Miss Kansas.
Brenda K. Kottmeyer. She has blonde hair, lovely green eyes, 18 years old. She's from Overland Park. 5 feet 7 inches tall and weighs 123 pounds.
Miss Nebraska.
Janice Elaine Geller. 5 feet 9 1/2 inches tall and weighs 127 pounds. Blonde hair, green eyes. She's from Omaha. And she's 21 years old.
Miss Rhode Island.
Gail White, 5 feet 8 inches tall, weighs 125 pounds. She has brown hair and brown eyes to match. She's 21 years old, and she's from Providence.
Miss California.
And that, of course, is Carol Paramus. She's from Los Angeles. She has blonde hair and green eyes. She's 5 feet 8 inches tall, weighs 125 pounds, and she's 19 years old.
Miss Texas.
This lovely LaVon McConnell. She's 5 feet 10 inches tall and weighs 135 pounds. Lovely blonde hair and blue eyes. She's from Fort Worth and she's 20 years old.
Miss District of Columbia.
Nancy Plakta. She's from Adelphi. She has blonde hair and blue eyes. 5 feet 8 inches tall. 125 pounds and 22 years old.
Miss New York.
Susan Elizabeth Carlson, 19 years old, 5 feet 8 inches tall, and weighs 118 pounds. Brown hair, blue eyes, from Schenectady.
Miss Louisiana.
Sergeant Storm Hensley. 5 feet 7 1/2 inches tall, weighs 123 pounds. Blonde hair, lovely hazel eyes. She's from Barksdale, AFB. That's Air Force Base, of course. She's 22 years old.
Miss Illinois.
Amanda Jones from Evanston, 22 years old. She has brown hair, hazel eyes, 5 feet 8 1/2 inches tall, and weighs 125 pounds.
Miss Maryland.
Betty Jo Grove with blonde hair and blue eyes, 19 years old. She's from College Park. She's 5 feet 10 inches tall and weighs 132 pounds.
The 1973 Miss USA Swimsuit Competition. Now, girls, would you please walk by our judges one more time so they can have another close look at you. Miss Maryland, will you lead the way right down here, please?
Well, now that we've seen the 12 semifinalists in the swimsuit competition, it isn't hard to figure out why girl watching is still one of the nation's favorite pastimes and a very popular part of our pageant. Most of the girls worry less about the shape they're in than you'd think. I've even seen a few of them put away 3 desserts at mealtime and not show an ounce of it. Of course, they've been working very hard all week and get plenty of exercise throughout the year, no doubt. Being in New York has been a fascinating experience for all the girls. The Brooklyn Dodgers are gone. Just about everything else you can think of is still here. Shows, movies, concerts, art, art galleries. Yeah, when it comes down to what these beauties really care about, they're the same as girls everywhere. Now, the conversations I happened to overhear were mostly about their families, school, clothes, oh, and of course, boys. Now, while the girls are getting ready for a big musical number, here's a word about an antiperspirant especially made for women.
Each year, the pageant welcomes back several former Miss USA title holders, and this year, three of those lovely ladies are with us. Now, you've already met Maria Remenyi, Miss USA of 1966, who's one of our judges tonight. And now, I'd like to present the others, if I may. First, Miss USA of 1970, Debbie Shelton. And now may I introduce Miss USA of 1971, Michelle McDonald. Thank you very much, ladies. It's always a pleasure to have you with us during pageant week. Now, of course, only one of our girls can become Miss USA each year. But every one of our 51 contestants has already won her state title, so you might say we have a pageant of winners. That we do. And even the girls who don't win the big title have a once-in-a-lifetime experience that is rewarding and memorable. Memorable? Memorable. While our 12 semifinalists are getting ready for the evening gown competition, the other delegates have a song for you to tell you just how they feel at this very moment. It's a special lyric to a great song by Richard Morris and Meredith Wilson from the unsinkable Molly Brown. It's called, I Ain't Down Yet.
Right back. I'm gonna win.
wish I had a crystal ball that would show me what was in the future for some of our contestants, but I can tell you how they think their lives are going to go. I made a few notes. 9 are planning to be teachers, 4 lawyers, and 1 has dentistry in mind. We have 3 hopeful actresses, 1 nurse, and 1 young lady who plans to be a veterinarian. And would you believe she's a sergeant in the Air Force already? A few of the girls just don't know what they want in the way of a career yet. And according to their interviews, they're willing to settle for just, well, good health and happiness. Who wouldn't? Most of our beauty queens hold part-time jobs while going to school. One girl drives a bus, another's a lifeguard, and still another is the leader of a dance combo. One young lady told me she was a groom at a racetrack and had to get up at 4:30 in the morning to get to her job. Most of the girls really want to be wives and mothers eventually, but they tell me they're just not ready to get married. Well, not quite yet, anyway. But why don't we go on a little honeymoon with Head & Shoulders shampoo?
For the Miss USA evening gown competition, each of the girls chooses her own gown, so it's a good time for you and our judges to learn a little bit about each girl's personality and fashion sense. In addition to seeing the girls on stage, the judges will see them on close-up television monitors, which have been set up in the judges' box. The monitors will allow them to see each semifinalist just exactly as you see her at home on your own television screen. So, judges, if you will direct your attention to your television monitors, I will introduce our 12 semifinalists. Here is the 1973 Miss USA Evening Gown Competition. Miss Arizona. Miss Florida. Miss Kansas. Miss Nebraska. Miss Rhode Island. Miss California. Miss Texas. Miss District of Columbia. Miss New York. Miss Louisiana. Miss Illinois. Miss Maryland. The 12 semifinalists in tonight's evening gown competition. Now, judges, will you please mark your ballots and choose five Miss USA finalists for us?
Well, you've seen all the semifinalists in both swimsuits and gowns. And from the interviews, you know how very delightful they are. Now, it's time to put the names of your five favorites on a list. Later on, the whole family can check to see who came closest to matching the judges' selections. Make your picks just the way the judges do. Rate the delegates in both events, not just one of the two. Now, when the judges are finished marking their ballots, they'll be turned over to the accountants to be tallied along with the votes the judges cast after the personal interviews made during the week. No one knows who the winner will be since the judges vote secretly and don't compare notes. It's all up in the air until Bob Barker announces the finalists. Since the very first Miss USA pageant, people have changed, and so have clothes. And now cheers, all temperature cheer.
Right now, we're going to give you one more opportunity for a close-up look at each of our 12 semi-finalists so that you can choose the five girls that you think should become finalists. Because we want to help you choose the winner, we'll even tell you their zodiac signs. The judges have met and talked personally with each girl, but this final close-up might show them a smile or a special sparkle that they think is worthy of the Miss USA title. Watch closely now as we present our 12 semi-finalists. Here they are. Miss Arizona. She's an Aries. Aries act on impulse, are inclined to be generous spenders, and have an active and dynamic personality. Miss Florida is a Cancer. Her sign indicates vivid imagination and a sympathetic nature that draws her to all types of people. Miss Kansas is a Scorpio. This sign indicates a highly emotional love life. When Scorpios find a compatible person who understands the depths of their nature, they are one of the most exciting companions. Miss Nebraska. Miss Nebraska is a Gemini. Versatility is a strong characteristic of this sign, as is a reluctance to make decisions. Miss Rhode Island, a Sagittarian. There's always a bit of rebel in this sign, but good nature and the desire to share the burdens of others dominate. Miss California. Miss California is a Leo. Leos have a good sense of humor and a tendency toward leadership. They're courageous to the point of daring. Miss Texas, a Taurus. Those of this sign are not very adaptable to changes of environment or people and tend to find a place they like and friends they love and make very few changes. Miss District of Columbia is an Aquarius. This sign indicates a deep understanding and feeling for humanity on a broad spectrum. Aquarians have plenty of personal magnetism. Miss New York. Miss New York is a Taurus. This sign indicates great determination and strength of will, as well as a desire to mold other people to her way of thinking. Miss Louisiana, a Pisces. Pisces people enjoy life in a completely uninhibited way and know how to build one success upon another. Miss Illinois is a Scorpio. This sign indicates keen perception and a positive will. Scorpios are independent thinkers and are active, industrious, and very capable. Miss Maryland, a Virgo. She is quietly active, reserved, and sometimes shy. The good work and kindness of a Virgo often go by unnoticed. And there they are, awaiting the judge's decision, our Miss USA semifinalists for 1973.
selections for the five finalists, or are you still making up your mind? Just imagine what the judges are going through right now. You know, lots of people ask me how we here at the pageant can manage to see that 51 girls get to rehearsals, costume fittings, or even breakfast on time. The hours are very precious when you have just a week to prepare a show like this. And the real job falls on the shoulders of our unpaid volunteer hostesses. Each one is in charge of three girls, generally from a nearby state. Now, most of these fine ladies have children themselves, so they know how to comfort the girls when a minor crisis arises, such as a stomach ache right before an interview or a missed phone call from home. The hostesses live with the girls, shepherd them everywhere, and become sort of substitute mothers. It's wonderful to see the bonds of affection that form between our hostesses and their girls during one short week. They do a splendid job, and they deserve a great deal of praise. Well, it's just about time to find out who the five lucky finalists are. But first, let's turn our attention to your hands and this word from Ivory Liquid.
Each year I have a chance to talk to many of the judges to find out what qualities they look for in a potential Miss USA. Each judge has his own particular definition of beauty, but one thing on which they all agree is that selecting 12 beautiful girls, and then five, and then just one from so many charming and radiant young ladies is a difficult job that they take very seriously. Now, this year's judges have voted, and the firm of Ernst & Ernst has tabulated their secret ballots. The five finalists in the 1973 Miss USA Beauty Pageant have been chosen, and one of them will be crowned Miss USA right on this stage within a very few minutes. Now, may I have the card with the names of the five finalists, please? Here are the five names from which our four runners-up and the new Miss USA will come. Now, girls, you have all competed beautifully. From the moment that you became a semi-finalist, you have just been a joy to watch. Good luck to all 12 of you. The first of our five finalists is Miss Illinois. Goodness, judges, I almost feel as if I should ask you to take a bow on this one. The second name on this list, Miss Arizona. Now, the waiting is over for Miss Illinois and Miss Arizona, but from our remaining semifinalists, there are three more girls who have a chance to become Miss USA. Who are they? Well, one of them is Miss Maryland. Yes. We have Miss Illinois, we have Miss Maryland, we have Miss Arizona, we have two more names, and one of those names is Miss New York. Now, only one more girl among the semifinalists who has a chance to go on to victory, to become Miss USA of 1973. Only one more, and that one is Miss Rhode Island. Yes, there are our five contenders for the title of Miss USA of 1973. Congratulations, finalists. And now we have come to the final phase of tonight's competition, and the last chance for our five beautiful finalists here to make one last important impression on our panel of judges, this time in an informal and impromptu question and answer situation. Now, finalists, I am going to ask each of you the same general interest question so that our judges will have a chance to judge you on your poise and the manner in which you deliver your spontaneous answer. Now, I shall begin with you, Miss Rhode Island. Will you please step right over to this microphone? Step to this microphone. There we are. And now, will all four of you step over here into this soundproof booth? Right here. Miss Hospitality, would you put them in there? And we do this, girls, so that you cannot hear the answer of another one of our beauty delegates, and you will not hear the question until you're called out of the soundproof booth. There you are. Close the door, Miss Hospitality. And now, Miss Rhode Island, the judges are here, as you can see and as you well know. I'm going to ask you this question. Please direct your answer to them. If you had to move forward or backward in time, what period of history would you like to visit and why?
If I had to move forward or backward in time, I'd like to move to the 1940s because of the style of the clothing that people wore, the shoes, the hats, the beautiful everything's in the 1940s, the music and the happiness.
Thank you, Miss Rhode Island. You have a seat right here, please. Now, would you come out, Miss Maryland, please? We'll have you answer our question next. Now, Miss Maryland, our judges await your answer to this question. If you had to move forward or backward in time, what period of history would you like to visit and why?
I think I'd like to go into the future because it holds such great opportunities. I just think that the world is going to be so much better in the future, and I'd like to live then. I'm not really cutting down the present because I do like the present, but the future just seems to be so great for this nation. It really does.
Miss Maryland, thank you. Would you join Miss Rhode Island here? Now, Miss Illinois, would you please step out here to the microphone, Miss Illinois? And would you please speak to our judges? And the question is, if you had to move forward or backward in time, what period of history would you like to visit and why?
I think I would like to live in the Renaissance, not only because the times had just come out of a very serious and depressing period, but because that was indeed the most creative period in human history for art, music, and the theater.
Very well, Miss Illinois. You have a seat right here. Now, Miss New York. Miss New York, would you step right up here to our microphone, please? And the judges would like to hear your answer to this same question that each of these girls has already answered. And the question is, if you had to move forward or backward in time, what period of history would you like to visit and why?
I think I'd like to just stay right where I am because I think these
times... But, Miss New York, now, just a moment, let me interrupt. I'm sorry. The question is, if you had to move forward or backward in time, if you could not stay in the present, what period of history would you like to visit and why? I'm sure you're a very happy girl in the present, and particularly at this very moment. But if you had to move forward or backward, if you move forward, you're in the orchestra pits, so be careful of that. But in history.
I think that I'd like to move forward because I think that things are just getting better all the time, and I think that that would be the place to move. Thank you.
Thank you, Miss New York. Right here. And now, Miss Arizona, would you please step up to our microphone here and speak directly to the judges and tell the judges, if you had to move forward or backward in time, what period of history you would like to visit and why?
I think if I could visit any period of history in time, it would have to be the past. There have been so many things that have happened, not to mention a few of the Civil War, which I think is one of the greatest movements our country has ever made towards peace, understanding, so on. And I would love to go back and see exactly how those people thought back then, and then just tell them a little bit of how great we are now. Thank you.
Yes. And I must say, I must say, and I think our audience will agree, that in a situation such as they find themselves at this very moment, with so much pressure on them to have answered this question as well as they did, we have five very bright young ladies here. The judges, you have now heard our finalists, and the pageant is in your hands. And we're all anxious to know who will be Miss USA of 1973. Now, girls, while our judges are marking their ballots for the last time, I mentioned the fact that you're under great pressure. I am going to try to relieve the tension just a bit by bringing back our musical guest stars. Let's welcome the Lettermen.
Precious and few are the moments we two can share. Precious and few are the moments we two can share. Baby, it's you on my mind, your love is so rare. Being with you is a feeling I just can't compare. I can't hold you in my arms, it just wouldn't be fair. Cause precious and few are the moments we two can share. Cause precious and few are the moments we two can share. Precious and few are the moments we two can share. Quiet and blue like the sky, precious and few are the moments we two can share. Moments we two can share.
Just about down to the wire now, aren't we? I've written down my choices for the four runners-up and the girl that I think will be Miss USA 1973, and I'm sure you have too. Bob's final question should have helped you somewhat, but all the girls are so uniquely lovely that your final choice may just be based on her resemblance to a special person in your life. Some of you may have a preference for a perky blonde or a saucy brunette. If one of the girls looks like your own daughter, well, then I bet you select her. And you men out there, well, you'll probably pick the girl who seems most like your wife or maybe your dream girl. Personality, looks, and poise are the qualities to judge. It's fun to guess the outcome from home, but the tough part is really up to the judges. And while they're laboring down there, we'll pause for this note.
Now, while our judges are making their final decision, I would like to introduce once more the reigning Miss USA for her traditional walk and words of farewell. Here is Miss USA of 1972, Tanya Wilson.
All the winners of the Miss USA pageant who have gone before me have spoken of the thrills and excitement their reign has brought them. I'd like to share with you instead a poem that was given to me some years ago. Life is sweet just because of the people I meet and the things which in common we share. I want to live on, not just for myself, but because of the people who care. It's giving and doing for someone else. On that, all life's splendor depends. And the real joy in this world, when I've summed it all up, is found in the making of friends. Thank you.
And now may I have the final decision, please. The judges have just handed me their list of four runners-up and Miss USA of 1973. Now, this is the decision we've been waiting for all evening. Of course, these young ladies have been waiting for this decision all year long. And for one last time, girls, let me say good luck to all of you. I will read the fourth runner-up, third, second, first, and then Miss USA. The fourth runner-up for the title of Miss USA is Miss Maryland. The third runner-up is Miss Arizona. The second runner-up is Miss Rhode Island. Step right down here with me. Now, one of you young ladies will be Miss USA of 1973, and the other young lady will be our first runner-up. And this position of first runner-up is very important because if for any reason Miss USA cannot fulfill her obligation, then the first runner-up takes her crown. The first runner-up is Miss New York. Miss USA. Put the banner on her. Tanya knows how this works. There you go. And I want you to hear her first words. Would you please repeat? They were applauding so they didn't hear you. Would you repeat what you said to me?
I said, "You aren't kidding, are you?"
No, we are not kidding. You are Miss USA, and I would like to have Tanya Wilson read the Miss USA creed as you go out and greet this beautiful audience as Miss USA. Right out here you go.
Everywhere are seeking peace, tolerance, and mutual understanding. We pledge to spread this message in every way we can, wherever we go.
Yes, Amanda, I can't think of a brighter young lady among our 51 delegates to be our Miss USA. I know you're going to have a marvelous reign. Tell us now, who will be the first person you call?
The lady who entered me in the Illinois pageant.
Well, how did you happen to enter the Illinois pageant, and who is that lady?
Her name is Molly. She works for a talent agency I'm signed with at home. And I said, when she asked me to enter, "Molly, I'm not the type." And she said, "Amanda, it'll be good for you. You'll learn something."
Well, now, Amanda, First of all, she was right when she encouraged you to enter. Now I'd like to know, what have you learned since you became a beauty candidate?
For one thing, that the things that separate people, like state boundaries and hair color or statistics, are really minimal in comparison with all the many things that people have in common.
Who's your roommate?
Arizona.
And have you ever visited Arizona? Do you know anything about the state of Arizona?
Yes, I do.
Have you met some girls from the South or from the West or here from the East that who are from states you did not know before?
As I say, it's not the state barrier, it's the girls themselves.
Well, the girls themselves have a great deal in common, don't they?
Yes, indeed.
And this is a beautiful place for it to all happen here in New York City, is it not?
I think you'd better stop asking me questions because I'm about to have a coronary.
Oh, no. Don't do that. You're going to be a wonderful Miss USA. And this girl is going to represent our country in the Miss Universe pageant from Athens, Greece, on July 21st, when you'll see it on CBS by satellite. Now, Bob Barker is saying good night, everybody.
Well, there she is, Miss USA 1973, Amanda Jones from Illinois. Out of 51 lovely delegates from all over the United States, this beautiful girl has been selected to represent our nation in the pageant that chooses the most beautiful girl in the world, Miss Universe, which will be televised via satellite from Athens, Greece, on July 21st. Remember the date, because I'm sure you won't want to miss it. For Amanda Jones, this is the beginning of a year she'll never forget. There'll be great adventures in store for her. And who knows, with all of you rooting for her, she just might win the title of Miss Universe as well. Gee, I hope you had a good time judging the pageant from your seat as I did from mine. But most of all, I hope you enjoyed the show. This is Helen O'Connell saying goodnight for Bob Barker and myself. Night.
The Miss USA Beauty Pageant was presented live by the makers of Crest, the Cavity Fighter, and by Mild Ivory Liquid, helps keep your hands young-looking, and by All Temperature Cheer for the way you wash now.